And we're now joined by DFA Migrant Workers Affairs Secretary, Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega. Yusek De Vega, good morning to you.
Good morning, madam.
All right. So what do you know about the ban? When does this start? And when did they send you the official notice?
Yes, thank you. The official notice was received yesterday. The Kuwaiti Embassy informed the Philippine Department of Foreign Affairs and our ambassador in Kuwait, Ambassador Peps Cabrera, Jose Peps Cabrera, was able to get this confirmed from the foreign ministry. As he announced, it wasn't the foreign ministry which announced this. It was the an office under the Ministry of Interior. So he had to verify it. So it's applicable as of Wednesday. It does not mean that all Filipinos are banned. In other words, they will not issue new entry visas for Filipinos. The great majority of visas anyway are working visas. So obviously this was in response to a decision you mentioned made last February, as announced by the government, by the DMW secretary, Secretary Susanote, that we were suspending the deployment of new or first-time household workers. So what Kuwait did now was to say, well, if that's the case, well, let's expand it to all so that we won't hire other workers as well. Because roughly 30% of our kababayans in Kuwait are not household workers. The majority are, over two-thirds, about 70, maximum 75% are household workers. So what Kuwait is saying is, well, we won't take other workers then. So that is obviously their response and some measure of pressure, shall we say, for the Philippines to reconsider its decision.
Okay. What was exactly contained in this labor agreement for Kuwait to claim that the Philippines was non-compliant? Ano ba laman nun, sir?
Yun naman po yung proseso. Nandun naka lahat sa agreement na to na pinirma natin noong 2018 after this controversy. Baka may naalala nyo to noong 2018. Medyo napikon yung Kuwait or sabihin diplomatically, hindi nila nagustuhan yung mga video na lumalabas na sinasagit, nire-rescue ng Philippine government yung gagawa doon, di ba? Yung na-film pa sila. Well, actually, that is a measure of violation. Uh-oh. That is violation of their sovereignty. Dapat police ginagawa nila. So, under that agreement, nakaset yung procedure paano magde-deploy. Ang sinasabi po nilang violations natin, and this is through verbal, in the past several years, one, meron tuloy pa yung ating shelter dun sa Kuwait. Sabi nila, under Kuwaiti law, dapat walang shelter for runaway workers. But then again, under Philippine law, we have to have those shelters. And of course, it is the obligation of the Philippine government to protect them. We are not encouraging them to escape from the employers, no? I mean, kung yun ang kinakatakutan ng mga Kuwaitis, but in the case of abuses and they have to leave, then they have to have a place to go to. And therefore, that's one issue. The second issue that they were complaining about is that whenever there's a complaint about labor abuse, we ask the foreign placement agency, the one in Kuwait, which placed contact the employer, and sabi nila, hindi raw applicable yan under Kuwaiti law. So there are these issues. They are not clearly defined in the agreement kung whether these are violations or not. So that's something that we have to sit down and discuss with them.
Okay. So, but what does it state in the labor agreement itself? I'm curious. Does it state in the labor agreement the shelter must be removed, etc., etc.? Because it says there's an agreement.
Yes, it doesn't mention the shelter. It mentions it in the minutes of the meeting that they requested and that the Philippines was going to address the issue. That's diplomatic language for, well, we'll see what we can do about this. No, but here's the issue, Ms. Karen. No, are we going to remove the shelters or are we going to lift the ban? We imposed the ban because of the heinous crime committed against our kababayans. Now the Kuwaitis are saying, well, in that case, we won't hire any workers. And that's not really a surprise. In other words, the timing was a surprise that they issued this, but that action, not really. Some governments would do that. If a foreign government said that we won't send you workers, okay, then that's it. But will we lift the ban? Given that we're still seeking justice for Jollibee Ranara, given that there are a lot of abused Filipino workers who escape from their employers and go to our shelters, given that it's been a long-standing issue. Ms. Karen, I'm a foreign service officer. I've worked in the service for over 30 years. I remember the very first interview I gave. I was a junior officer in 1993. It was about Kuwait. I was a director for Gulf States Division. I was a junior officer. I was not even 30 years old yet. And it was about Kuwait, about the runaway maids there. No? Now, 30 years later, we still have this issue. So you will understand why we said, okay, we will continue to deploy, but only non-household workers while we see what we can do to improve the condition of household workers. Because the agreement is a good agreement in terms of the commitment of each side to protect, to regulate the deployment. But maybe that still has to be strengthened as to how to avoid the deployment or
okay.
Dapat it has been suggested, dapat siguro may psychological test yung mga Kuwaiti.
Yes, okay. So, Undersecretary, moving forward, after Kuwait's announcement, does this mean that the Philippines will lift the ban on the deployment of first-time workers? Are we lifting that in, you know, as an effort to show Kuwait that, because in terms of a PR stand, of course, by installing the ban, we are saying that Kuwait is unsafe. So this is the return of Kuwait, right? This is how they've responded to the ban, among other things, perhaps. Does this mean the Philippines is considering lifting the ban?
Right now, I can't give an answer to that yet because we are still discussing among ourselves, and it's not just the Department of Foreign Affairs. It will be with the Department of Migrant Workers. We'll have meetings today. We hope to engage the Congress as well, eventually give recommendations to the President. But about lifting the ban, all right. So far, we have not yet said that, okay, they did this to us, then we lift the ban. Kasi po, Karen, so what happens if other countries do the same? Well, okay, we apply pressure in the Philippines and then they will fold.
Yeah.
Like our workers, parang, ay, ganun pala eh, kayang-kaya pala eh. Kung suspendin lang natin lahat ng workers, bibigyan ng Pilipinas. So we won't just leave the ban just like that. No. I'm sure the family of Jollibee Ranara is listening, and we guarantee that we will continue the fight for justice. In fairness, we want to thank Kuwait. They are moving on it. They have arrested and arraigned the suspect. So that's a positive development. So as for lifting the ban, right now, we're not deciding that yet. But it doesn't mean we won't. Pwedeng permanent ban to, no? But we'll have to sit down and discuss the proper timing and discuss it with the Kuwaiti authorities. There were supposed to be meetings this month. Maybe we'll have to move it a bit make a decision which will protect our workers and also ensure them full access to justice.
Okay. Undersecretary, are we going to meet? Is the DFA going to meet and the Department of Migrant Workers going to meet with Kuwaiti officials regarding the ban soon?
Yes.
Are we going to appeal that they rethink this ban or that they lift it?
What's going to happen is we're going to appeal and they're going to appeal. It will be a mutual appeal, I'm sure. So we may have to put some provisions to the labor agreement or otherwise have some sort of paper indicating how we'll move forward. Of course, we still have a solid bilateral relations. This is just one aspect of the relation. So we will say that it's to the best interest of both countries that we not have a ban. So we'll see. Of course, we'll need the inputs also of the public. It's not just the government. And your inputs, you're also part of the public in case of media.
I'm curious how many Filipinos will be affected with the ban. Now that COVID has imposed the ban and has said only Filipinos with residence permits are allowed, ilan po ba ang applicants who already have pending job offers? How many of them will not be able to go to Kuwait?
Okay, I invite you to interview makapanayam ninyo si Secretary Tuns Ople, who told me she has the statistics. But what I can tell you about the current statistics, there are about 275 to 300,000 Filipinos in Kuwait. Almost all have a residency. There are about 5 to 10,000 of them who don't have, are undocumented. So for those who already are there and have residency, they will be allowed to come home.
Yeah.
They can go back. As for yung papunta doon, the DMW has those issues, but there's not that many non-household workers who are now being deployed. Yeah. Di ba naghahanap yung DMW ng iba-ibang other countries para, kung saan pwede magtrabaho mga Pilipino? So that's one aspect of the issue, no? So that's to be considered as well. So they'll have the numbers, but it's not that massive, ha, yung ma-affect na hindi bigla makakapunta sa Kuwait.
Okay. On another note, I wanted to ask you, Senator Nancy Binay actually, I think, tweeted or shared a photo of an ad regarding Philippine nurses in the UK. And I wanted to ask you who's in charge of that. I believe the ad was it was on a bus, and it said something about the Filipino nurse being the first to administer the COVID-19 vaccine, and then it said something like, "We give you the best, the Philippines. We give you the best." And she asked, "What was the message of that ad? Who was in charge of that ad?"
I will have to check that, because it was not the Department of Foreign Affairs. It wasn't the embassy. I would believe, because it's the Department of Migrant Workers under kagalang-galang na Secretary Ople, who's in charge of deployment.
Yeah.
I think that kind of ad must have been issued, and I'm only speculating, but I'm using logical speculation, by recruitment agencies.
Oh, okay. Good one.
Private. Madam, there's no way we're going to spend public money to put an ad on a public bus. We don't do that. So it must have been the recruitment agency, but you could verify it also with the DMW. So PFA, DMW, or DOH, which would issue.
All right, Undersecretary, anything else you'd like to add?
Yes, we're committed to resolving this issue with Kuwait diplomatically, find a diplomatic solution with all countries, especially with countries who do indicate that they do need our workers. Yun lang po, we're still seeking justice for kababayans, not just for those who were killed, but also in abuse. So we have to balance all the interests involved. But thank you for this opportunity to explain our side.
As always, it's a pleasure to have you on Head Start. DFA Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega, thank you, sir.
Thank you. Good morning.